We heard in the news that a barbaric attack took place in New Zealand. So barbaric that an immigrant decided that other immigrants were less entitled than him, forgetting that he himself was not from there. He's not originally from that place. He comes from somewhere else. But because his color was white, he decided, I'm going to kill these Muslims because they came later on. I'm more entitled to this place than them. And what did he say? He said, I'm revenging, and these people who have come here are not supposed to have come. These immigrants are all extremist Muslims who have come, etc. That's not true, not at all. Because of people's comments over a long time in the media and elsewhere and on social media against Muslims, painting all Muslims with the same brush, yet it's a small number of Muslims who perpetrate crimes in the name of Islam that you and I know are not a part of. Because of the acts of a few, it does not make everyone bad. But my brothers and sisters, that's exactly what we are saying about Islam. To say that you see these acts that are being perpetrated, they are using our name, they are saying we are Muslims across the globe, killing, fighting. Some Muslims believe that non-Muslims don't have a right to exist. That is a deviant ideology. That is wrong. Some Muslims believe that you've got to kill the non-Muslims. The number who believe that is very small. Percentage-wise, it is probably less than 0.00 something percent. But don't we all get blamed for it? When people look at you and they see you're a Muslim, they start saying, hey, these guys are terrorists. I believe around us, our brothers and sisters of other faiths and their leaders need to talk about the good that Islam has. Sometimes intentionally, people have come to me and told me that in our churches we heard how horrible Muslims are. And I think to myself, in our mosques, we don't ever talk about how horrible others are. A lot of the Muslims who were killed today were professionals, people who delivered to society. They served communities irrespective of the faith of the people there. Doctors and accountants perhaps, lawyers and teachers and so many others. Charity workers, those who are very good neighbors to their non-Muslim neighbors. As the days pass, we will find out more about these victims, the individuals. And the loss was for the society and community of New Zealand to begin with, and thereafter for humanity at large. And the only reason I speak about it today is to show, number one, solidarity. To stand in solidarity with the victims. And to tell you that New Zealand is an absolutely beautiful country. It is a very peaceful nation. The people of New Zealand do not stand for what happened today. Just like if something were to happen in our place, may Allah forbid, does it mean we stand for that violence? No, it doesn't.